Good morning, everybody. Today we'll discuss Gleason score. I'm Dr. Nitin Joshi, professor in urology with teaching experience of 25 years, working as consultant urosurgeon in Panvel. So we are going to discuss Gleason score. Now the questions which are asked in exam are: what is Gleason's grading system? The Gleason's grading system is the most commonly used grading system for cancer prostate. It is based on the architectural appearance and not on the cytological appearance. It is purely architecturally based. What do you mean by architecturally based? That is, what is the structure, shape, size and the spacing of the acini, and it does not depend upon the cytological appearance. That is, it does not depend upon the nuclear cytoplasmic changes, that is vacuolation of cytoplasm, enlargement of the size of the nucleus. These changes in the cytological appearance will not affect the grading system. The next question which can be asked: which stain is used for preparing slide for Gleason's grading system? Hematoxylin eosin stain, HE stain, is used for preparing slide for Gleason's grading system. The next question which can be asked: the slide which is prepared for Gleason's grading system is studied under which power of lens? The slide which is prepared for the Gleason's grading system is studied under low power lens of 10x. The next question which can be asked is: what are the other names of Gleason's grading system and why? The Gleason's grading system is also called as Gleason's sum or Gleason score. Gleason sum, this is because there is addition of mostly two patterns, sometimes three patterns. So sum of two patterns and addition of these two or sometimes three gives one number which is called as Gleason's score. So Gleason's sum and Gleason's score. What do you mean by two or three different patterns and what is the pathology behind this? Cancer prostate is multicentric. Many of the cancer prostates are heterogeneous. That is, even in a given prostate tumor, the origin of tumorogenesis takes place at different sites, and these tumors which are arising from different sites may follow the different molecular pathways. So the cells which are giving rise to following the different pathways, they show different biologic, so that their appearance is also different structurally. So the pattern of the cancer depends upon the molecular pathways followed by these cancer cells. So these different sites giving rise to different morphological patterns, and the studies have shown that sometimes even one cell can give rise to the different patterns because one cell can go along the two different molecular pathways of pathogenesis of tumor. So different morphological patterns of the cancer arising from different tumor cells at different sites in a given tumor, or the same tumor cell giving rise to different patterns of the tumor even at the from one cell. So different or distinct patterns. So now the next question which will be asked, that when a particular pattern is considered as a separate pattern in Gleason's system, what is the criteria for that? So there are maybe two or three or even sometimes more patterns, but to be considered as a distinct separate pattern, to be considered from the prognostic point of view, from therapeutic point of view, that particular pattern should occupy at least 5% of the tumor. If the tumor is not occupied by that particular pattern up to 5%, then that pattern has to be neglected. So the pattern, even if there are multiple patterns, it has got significance from clinical point of view, provided it occupies 5% of the tumor. Now, when the Gleason score is given by a formula A plus B, what does it stand for in prostate needle biopsy and radical prostatectomy specimen? When the Gleason score or sum is given by a formula A plus B, that is two patterns A plus B, then in case of the prostate needle biopsy, A stands for the most common or prevalent form found in the tumor. That is, in that particular tumor, the most common pattern found is A. That is, that particular pattern, most common pattern. While in case of B, in prostate needle biopsy, it is the worst grade or the highest grade found in the specimen. While in case of radical prostatectomy, again A stands for the most common pattern found in the specimen, but B stands for the next most common pattern found in the radical prostatectomy specimen. In radical prostatectomy specimen, even the tertiary pattern is taken into consideration, provided it is more than 5% of percent, and if it is the worst pattern, that is, if the worst pattern is not shown by the primary pattern or the secondary pattern, then tertiary pattern has to be taken into account from the prognostic point of view. Now, if suppose tumor is not heterogeneous but homogeneous, then how the Gleason sum is given? So if it is not heterogeneous, that is homogeneous, that is only one pattern is found, in that case the most common pattern as well as the worst pattern is the same, and then the common pattern, whatever is the grade, is to be added with the same number so as to give the sum. For example, if it is 3 plus 3 is a homogeneous to give a Gleason score of 6, that is the most common pattern as well as the worst pattern in the prostate needle biopsy is 3, so 3 plus 3. Similarly, if in prostate needle biopsy, if the most common pattern found is 4, grade 4, and the worst pattern found in prostate needle biopsy is again 4, then 4 plus 4, that is 8. Similarly, 10, that is, if the most common or prevalent form found in the biopsy is 5 and the worst pattern found is also 5, then it is 5 plus 5, that is 10. So they are homogeneous, there is only one pattern, no additional pattern is found. Now, in Gleason sum, formula, that is A plus B, is given. The A is given sum number and even B is given sum number. What does this number stand for and what is their significance? So, these patterns which have been found, they are evaluated under low microscope and they are given the numbers depending upon degree of differentiation. These are different grades. With these grades are grade 1, 2, 3, 4 and 5. That is, most well differentiated pattern is grade 1. While the worst differentiated, poorly differentiated, anaplastic pattern, that is grade, will be grade 5. Now, the most differentiated will have the appearance similar to normal acini. That is, these acini will have normal size, shape and spacing in the surrounding stroma. Now, normally they are medium size, regular round with regular spacing in the stroma. According to the recent modification of the Gleason's grading system, the grade 1 and grade 2 has been discarded. So they have not been used in the practice. So only grade 3, grade 4 and grade 5 are included in the sum system. So the grade 3 is considered to be the least malignant grade. So this grade, which is seen, it is also showing the glandular pattern, but there is significant variation in terms of the size, shape and spacing of acini in the surrounding stroma, and even the cancer acini are now infiltrating surrounding stroma and even some acini. Now the grade 4 will show that there may be a haphazard arrangement of the acini, fusion of the acini, and even the differentiation of the glandular pattern has poor differentiation. It is very difficult to assess that they are really a glandular pattern. While the grade 5, where it is totally de-differentiated, totally anaplastic, loss of glandular pattern, cancer are present, cells in form of cells which are trabeculae sheets, and they are highly malignant. So the grade which was 1 and 2 has now been discarded from the routine use. So as per recent modification, there is elimination of grade 1 and grade 2. What is the significance? Now significance is that since the grade 1 and grade 2 has been eliminated, then in the sum or Gleason score, the 1 plus 1, that is 2, then 1 plus 2, that is 3, and 1 plus 2 plus 2, that is 4. All these Gleason scores have been eliminated. So up to 4, they are not at all considered as malignant. Now what is the significance of tumor having Gleason score 6? Now Gleason score 6 is actually showing it is a homogeneous. A plus B, that is the most predominant or common pattern found in the tumor, is 3, as well as the worst pattern found in the prostatonatal biopsy is also 3. Now the acini which are showing the grade 3 differentiation, they are glandular pattern, and the studies have shown there are no propensity or potential for infiltration and invasion. So the worst pattern also doesn't have the propensity of infiltration and invasion, as well as the most common pattern found in the tumor also is 3, and the studies have shown that the prognosis of the tumor or the tumor biology depends on the A, that is the most common predominant form found in the tumor, because a given tumor is occupied by that particular pattern of the tumor. And so if that tumor, which is also 3, which is least aggressive, least having potential for infiltration, invasion, it is a good prognosis because it doesn't have any propensity for infiltration, invasion or metastasis. What is the significance of tumor having Gleason score 7? Now Gleason score 7, there are two types of patients. There will be two groups. One where the Gleason score is 3 plus 4. 3 plus 4, that is the most, while the other group will be 4 plus 3. The sum will be same. So the score is 7. But one group is 3 plus 4 and second group 4 plus 3. In 3 plus 4, the most predominant pattern is 3. Most predominant pattern, that is the pattern found in major part of the tumor. And tumor prognosis, tumor biology depends upon this, that is the grade 3, which don't have any propensity for infiltration and invasion. But in second group, where the score is 7, but A, that is the most common predominant form in the tumor, is 4. And 4 has got propensity or potential for infiltration and invasion. And so even if the score is 7, the patient who is having 3 plus 4 have got better prognosis as compared to 4 plus 3. And so patient if been subjected for active surveillance, in that case, even if the score is 7, but if it is 4 plus 3, where the most common predominant form on which the tumor biology depends, prognosis depends is 4, then in a localized cancer prostate patient, he has got high risk and he should not offer active surveillance. So 4 plus 3 and 3 plus 4, score is same, but still the prognosis will be different. Now what is the significance of tumor having Gleason score 8? Now here it is homogeneous, but it is 4 plus 4. So the most common pattern is 4, and even the worst pattern is also 4 in prostate needle biopsy. But 4 means it got propensity, potential for infiltration and invasion. So it is an aggressive variety. Now what is the significance of Gleason score 9? Again there are two groups, and there is one where 4 plus 5 and 5 plus 4. Now both are aggressive because the degree of differentiation in grade 4 as well as grade 5 is poor. They both have got propensity for infiltration invasion. But group of patient A with this 4 plus 5, where 4 is the predominant pattern. So the major part of the tumor is occupied by 4. While in the second group where it is 5 plus 4, then the major part is occupied by the 5, which is totally poorly differentiated, de-differentiated, maximum potential for infiltration, invasion, metastasis. Thus, the prognosis of the patient with, only when you consider the Gleason score, prognosis of the patient with Gleason score of 9, but 4 plus 5, slightly better prognosis than 5 plus 4. And what is the naturally 5 plus 5? It is totally de-differentiated, such that there will be loss of glandular pattern, worse pattern, as well as everything is occupied by the poorly differentiated. So maybe it is highly progressive, highly infiltrative, highly metastatic, but still because of pure de-differentiation, the PSA produced by cell will be low. And so in spite of progression, the rise in serum PSA may not be in the similar proportion. Now, what is the significance of Gleason score? It is a very important prognostic factor. It is helps to decide the prostate cancer risk stratification in localized cancer. One can divide the patients into low, intermediate and high risk for the progression and the prostate cancer related death. Also, it gives the prognostic and person who is in active surveillance can be monitored for the progression of the disease depending upon the Gleason score. Because if the patient initially has Gleason score 6 and on the repeat biopsy within 6 months, if this progression to the 7, particularly 4 plus 3, it is upgrading, or if there is a progression of the disease, it is actually subclassification, where the patient now should not wait for the active surveillance but should go ahead with active radical prostatectomy or radical therapy, which is of curative intent. Now what are, depending upon the Gleason score, how the patients have been grouped into 5 groups. One, group 1, where the patient is having Gleason score less than or equal to 6. Group 2, where it is 7 but 3 plus 4, that is better prognosis. Group 3, where it is 7 but 4 plus 3, then group 4, 8, and then worse, that is 9 and 10. Now, how the patients are clinically staged and how it will be managed, we'll see in the next class. Thank you very much.